And we begin at 6 o'clock with an I-Team 8 investigation and a warning about Indiana's electric grid this winter. A new report suggests that a major winter storm could leave parts or all of the state without electricity.
This is a big deal. I-Team 8's Jasmine Miner obtained a copy of the report. Jasmine, what's been involved with this group that you were able to chat with?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you guys, you have to remember what happened in Texas in February. Okay, you remember that giant winter storm they had?
I have family who are still dealing with what happened from that point.
Yeah, totally blew out the entire. Well, that's what this report says could happen if we don't get a control of this with extreme weather, at least. And this report is from the North American Electric Reliability Council, who says Texas and the Midwest are the two areas that could see blackouts if another major storm hits this winter.
The grid is prepared in the Midwest to handle winter.
Winter is one thing. An extreme winter storm in Indiana, like the February storm in Texas, could be something completely different.
It's that extreme stuff that that we need to be concerned about and not take our supply of electricity for granted.
The NERC report issued just last week says extreme winter weather or a long bout of bitter cold weather could expose vulnerabilities to the power grid that serves much of Indiana. NERC Manager of Reliability Assessments Mark Olson says a big part of that is Indiana's dependence on natural gas.
Natural gas is supporting a variety of needs from the space heating in people's homes and businesses, but it's also supporting the electricity generation. So we've got this condition where electricity supply is dependent on natural gas availability.
The Mid-Continent Independent System Operator, or MISO, is a utility grid based in Carmel. They tell me in a statement MISO supports the efforts of NERC and projected adequate resources for the winter season, but they say they're preparing for potential risks and volatility due to possible extreme weather. Still, Olson says avoiding what happened in Texas is critical.
Texas really bore the brunt of catastrophe earlier this year. I think it was a wake-up call for the electric industry.
Well, Olson tells me he doesn't think people need to panic and run out to buy generators and things like that, but we do need to recognize just how dependent we are on electricity, and so we need to be prepared this winter. I'm Jasmine Miner for WishTV, WishTV.com, and follow us on Facebook.